What happened to her? Oh, me. What happened to me? What happened to me? I'll make it. Here we go. Somebody died. You weren't paying attention, Sprite. What happened to you? Okay. Oh, we can use, her magic, right? You have it, don't you? I'll use this 10. Get that. Like this. Keep alive! This on. That's cheaper. There we go. What's up here? Nothing. What's this? Oh, there's the snake there, I remember. This thing, I died a whole bunch of times on this thing, but I feel like I was just rushing through it. This game. How do I want to go through this? Let's start with this on Jury. Thank you. Now it's something that you don't like. So I won. Once you go in here, it's like you're stuck. I don't know if that's true, but I'm making excuses right now. I this is nothing like before. When I was playing, this game as a kid, I was... You know, the thing is that, you can do a lot with a lot of time, but, that could be the reason why, Let's Players are so popular. Because, you know, when they're professional, they can do it. You can do almost anything. It's, you know, sort of, it's kind of like, you know, how, as a professional, network person, I'm able to, oh, ghosts. Spooky. Not really crazy about you guys. I don't get it. What is this area? Honestly, I don't know what that area is. We all came back, but I've already done it. Yeah, I mean, it'd be insane for me to do that all over again. Oh, neat. What is this? Yeah, okay. I'd love to save. Are you going to let me save again? You know I like saving twice. If you give me the option to save twice, I'm going to take it. But, yeah, it's like, to the left. Or right left, I say left. But, yeah, I mean, you can say that, like, the, help wire in a school, I mean. We're all good at something. So I mean, if you put your time into something, you'll eventually get better. Just a little how-to on doing portable Let's Play videos. So this is what I have. If you want to do something like what I'm doing right here, if this looks enjoyable, first of all, you have to figure out why you want to do it. And if this is even something that you can invest in, because this is a huge, huge project. I mean, this is almost like getting a computer, pretty much. But the advantages are that you're completely away from the system. It's like a Nintendo, but you can do Let's Plays. I know Nintendo has a big policy against videoing. I don't know exactly what the details are, but with this system, You can do indie games as well. If you think about, why would you want to do portable Let's Playing versus just setting up on your computer? Because with a computer, there's tons of free programs out there that allow you to do the exact same thing. Or a laptop, even. You can get a laptop and do the exact same thing. But to me, it's the setup, really. It's the time. So it's kind of balancing the time, setting up a computer versus plugging in and do it at a moment's notice. People who have lives beyond gaming, where they don't have a lot of time to just set up and do it, this is an ideal way of doing it. But why would you even want to record your gaming experience in the first place? It's an outlet to talk about stuff. You can talk about things while gaming. There's a lot of, if you enjoy gaming in the first place, then you can add to that experience. Especially if you enjoy doing combinations of gaming and blogging or anything like that, then this would be an ideal way of achieving that. And it's kind of a sets up a medium. It's not every YouTube channel does this, but there are a few that will talk about things like politics and other things that are going on. And it's there's nothing against doing something like that. But if you don't enjoy talking about politics, then it's just sharing the experience. There's also multiplayer. You can do multiplayer gaming with this, and I'm sure you can set up like a voice system. I haven't done that yet, but maybe that's something I might try later. Because this Android, the operating system Android on the NVIDIA Shield Portable, that's what runs on this, does have some it's multitasking. Am I saying that right? Multi-threading. Basically, it's capable of running multiple applications at the same time. The CPU can handle running different threads of the different processes. But it's there's a lot to it. So this is the NVIDIA Shield, which is going for $450 on Newegg. That's a lot of money. It's usually it's marketed at something a lot less, but I haven't seen the inventory come back on it, so I don't think you'll ever see it anywhere else. There are other options to go. A lot of even laptops you can plug an HDMI into. There are tablets that you can plug into. But I think for the best gaming experience, there's nothing like the NVIDIA Shield Portable. It's just something that you can put in a small sack, carry it with you, folds up really nicely, and you can take it out and play it anytime. Whereas if you're getting something like a tablet, then you're going to love the touch game and stuff, but it's still kind of bulky, I think, just to take out. So, and then you're going to need something to record it. So the one that I have is the HotPodge HD 1540 PVR Rocket 1080p video game recorder. You can get that almost anywhere. Amazon has it for $140. But I know Fry's has it. I don't know if Best Buy has it, but you can always check them out and see if they do. You also need an adapter to convert from the MIDI HDMI to the HDMI. You need an adapter because for some reason on the Hot Podge, at least for me, the audio wasn't picking up. So I had to get, I already had this, an Akanex K-A-N-E-X ATB Pro HDMI to VGA adapter for AirPlay, iPod, and Apple TV mirroring to VGA projectors with audio. That's just what's said on Amazon. So that's $34 about. So that plugs into the HDMI out of the Hot Podge. You need a USB stick. I have a 32 gig Lexer, which Office Depot sells for $40. And then you also need the HDMI to mini HDMI. I have a, I don't have this one in particular, but Triplight sells one called the Triplight HDMI to mini HDMI, which is sold at Office Depot for $14. So all that together, not including a headset, will get you the bare essentials to do portable Let's Plays. Yeah, I think it's worth giving it a try. That's it's a steep price, especially for the NVIDIA Shield. If you don't want to go that route, you could always swap it out for a tablet, but I think gaming-wise, the NVIDIA Shield Portable is going to be the way to go. I think it's just so simple to, to slap a game on this thing, and there's a whole bunch of games. The ones that I'm looking at included Raven Sword, Shadowlands, Dungeon Defenders Eternity, which I haven't been able to get working yet. Mount and Blade Warbands, which is really, it's something. I'm still learning it. There's Final Fantasy III, Frozen Synapse Prime, which I haven't tried yet. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, which is really good. This game, Secret of Mana, and Valiant Hearts, which is another one I haven't tried, but I'm looking forward to giving it a try. But I think for the experience, this is the way to go. I would do this even if I wasn't recording on the Hot Podge. But I think the Hot Podge, if you get the NVIDIA Shield, it's just $140 more for the Hot Podge, and then you can give it a try. You just throw it onto a USB stick. The important thing to do once it's recorded onto the USB stick is to use a program to shrink down the size of the video, because it's going to be 2 gigs once you get it out. And the program that I use, because I'm a Linux user, is so you'll definitely need a computer to process the video from here, but that's something you can do after hours and hours of recording. Because you gotta remember, this is 32 gigs for Lexer. That's 2 gigs every 20 or so minutes, so that can go for a long time. I think that might be a day or something, I'm not sure. It's 32, so 16 hours, I think. Yeah, that's a long time. It can go, it depends on what's being recorded. I use WinFF. It's a GUI for FFmpeg. You just Google WinFF. I think they have it for Windows, but I'm a Linux user, so that's what I use. And then I use throw the video, use using, you know, the standard YouTube upload to get onto YouTube. So let's get going. In addition to all the things I said, I mean, you can think of it as it being like a it's kind of like a kind of like a photo book of your gaming. That's something you can look back on and say, oh wow, I did this. I think Fetch's has mentioned that he's always wanted to have a history of his previous MMOs or something. So there's that too. There's a lot of different things that a lot of advantages to it. The disadvantage really is just that it'll take some time to set up. Basically, from pressing that big red button and plugging it all in. But once you get that done, so someone is basically pressing the big red button, and then on the weekend you plug the USB into the computer and upload your video content. I guess that could be a disadvantage. The cost is a big disadvantage. How are you going to recoup the cost? If you want to do it professionally, then it's going to take years. That's what I've heard. It's not going to be something that's just going to... You're not going to start getting money from Google, that's for sure. And by that time, Android, with all these possibilities, you might have to upgrade that $500 gaming system. But at the same time, you know, retro games will play on retro devices like the NES. And I believe the Hot Pod will work with that as well. Just depends on if you want to go that direction. And then it's, of course, your own image. Out of YouTube and, you know, build a site. If you have a lot of friends, do that. Have like a subscription-based system. Because videos are not owned by YouTube, they're owned by you. Except there's always that barriers you have to deal with. So if you do opt to go that direction, you might want to make it a closed website. And only give it out to people who you trust. You could always sell mugs and t-shirts, there's always that option. Let's see, what am I doing? I'm gonna do this. Oh, that's already on everyone. Let's do this for this guy. So it all really depends. You'll need a job or something to start the investment. Get it all. And that's gonna try for whole topic of horrible Let's Plays. Perfect. Get out of my way because I am going. Where am I going actually? That is weird. Why did it send me back here? Supposed to go right now. Oh, I remember. Okay. Let's keep going. There we go. So I did everything. Yeah, okay. Why is there more? Oh, I see. Cave was anyway, what is in the cave actually? Oh my god. What the heck is that? Dead end. I love it. I love those dead ends. I really love those dead ends. I'd be lying if I said I was lying, basically. Like a slime or, I don't know about you. I'm sure I can see you. Wow, this is a huge area. I do not remember any of this. I remember that snake and that's it. Yeah, I've heard you can do this. Let me see. I was kind of wondering. You can identify chests. Oh, swell, it's blinking. What does that mean? What does that mean? Bad, good? It's bad, right? I shouldn't open it. I don't know. Oh, this is the guy. I remember you. You remember me? I killed you. The guy that, crashed me. All sorts of stuff going on here. Alright. So it is time to take care of the bird brain. Fire.